Good morning to you. Yes, sir. Blessed. Highly favored. On the increase. Still in love. Jesus is still Lord. The devil's defeated and I'm delivered. We have been delivered out of his power and translated into the kingdom of his dear son. Blessed. Thinking about that, I'm blessed. Sitting here on my front porch, beautiful day, 72 degrees, wind's not blowing, sun's up, looking out over the lake, watching the hummingbirds, blessed. Bills are paid, walking in divine health, still have my first wife, in love, four wonderful children, all of them serving God, blessed. 11 grandchildren, blessed. I want to tell you, I'm blessed. Blessed, blessed, blessed. Go where I want to, when I want to. Blessed, get to preach the gospel, blessed. But I remember a time that I wasn't so blessed. Now, Pat and I got married at a very early age. We were 18. I pastored my first church when I was 19. Didn't know nothing. She was sick. I was sick. Then a year or two later, little babies started coming along. We were miserable. The church said, we'll keep him broke, Lord, if you'll keep him humble. I had two full-time jobs. Plus, I was going to college at Jacksonville State University, having a hard time. We moved to Maryland, living up there in a strange land. Having a hard time. Been sick. Man, I was sick. Pat was sick. The boys were sick. And a friend of mine came up and I said to him, I said, Jerry, we've been sick for over a month. What do we do? He said, don't receive it. I looked at him like he was crazy. I said, how do you don't receive what you've had for over a month? Dear God. He said, the Bible says you're blessed. So we went over to the church the next day and he said, Frank, how are you? I looked up, you know, I said, I'm under the circumstances. I'm doing okay. He said, what are you doing under there? I said, under where? He said, under them circumstances. I said, Jerry, I'm having a hard time. I got a young family. I'm broke. I'm miserable. He said, yeah, and you're going to stay that way. The Bible says you're blessed, Frank. And he taught me the beginning of where we started in faith to call things that be not as though they were. And Pat and I looked at him and said, if there's anybody in the world that's not blessed, it's us, man. We're struggling just to stay alive. And he said, yeah, and as long as you believe that and say that, you're going to keep struggling to stay alive. Say what the Word says. I said, okay, I'm blessed. And when I said it, I thought that was the biggest story I'd ever heard in my life. But man, look where we are today. You see, I changed my present circumstances by not looking at what they were, but saying what the Word said in spite of what my circumstances said. Don't talk the problem. Talk to the problem. Don't get up and say, I feel bad. Get up and say, I'm healed by the stripes of Jesus. Don't look at your checking account or in your wallet and say, you know, dear God, what are we going to do, Lord Jesus? Listen, start saying, I have an abundance and no lack. My wallet doesn't control how much my income is. My paycheck, back when I was working at other jobs, that doesn't control what I have. What I have is controlled by my, mouth. And I say wealth and riches are in my house. Yes, I'm blessed. I want to say it again. Yes, I'm blessed. My wife loves me, and I don't really understand why, but I'm glad she does. We're blessed. We do what we want to do. We have a great time. But we started saying it all because of what that friend of mine, he lives in Atlanta, said to me. Start saying what the Word says. Well, now we're so blessed, and he's in his latter years, that we're being able to be a blessing to him. You know, I've provided him with a car. I help pay some of his bills. I buy groceries for him, and I've been a blessing to him. And will continue to be so that nobody will ever have to take care of me when I'm old. Listen, but you're going to have to change your circumstances by saying what the Word says. I heard a little video, I believe I can find it again, where old Papa Hagen was making this statement. He said, I don't say the way it is. I say the way the Word says it is. Don't confess your doubt. Don't feed your doubt. Don't feed your fear. Feed your faith on what the promises of God says. And hey, Word says, Psalm 112, that I am on the increase. And so I'm blessed. Yes, I'm blessed. And so are you. But don't quit being blessed. Be on the increase. Because God wants you to be on the increase. Hey, have a great day. The blessings of God are overtaking me. The blessings of God are overtaking you. Start looking for them rather than the hard time. Woo, hallelujah. Hey, I got to do this. You know, somebody's got to do it. Blessings. Have a great day. Remember, Jesus is Lord. Yes, sir. The Word works.